Yeah, so it's a term that I came up with because I think there's a lot of us, and again, women of color I'm talking about, but there's a lot of us that were are the first in our family to go to college or work in a professional setting. And I mean, that is true of me and my generation. I'm not talking about like my mother's generation, right? I mean, my parents were immigrants. Like in my parents' families, most women didn't work outside the home, right? That's pretty normal. And I'm just talking about my experiences of Indian descent. That's true of a lot of the women of color of different ethnicities and different races that I'm meeting. They're one of the few because they are one of the only women of color in a department or in a group. Because again, even though we're saying that, you know, we're going to be the majority in 2060 right now, there's still a lot of us that are the one of the few in corporate spaces. And the only, what we're finding is most of the senior women. So when I say senior, I'm looking at VP level and above. They're the only one at their level. And again, more are rising and coming. Yes. If they don't leave, right? Like what we just talked about, right? But they're the first ones. And there's such a unique set of experiences and circumstances that come with that, right? You are feeling responsible for your entire race or your entire group. You are answering questions in a work setting around everything, right? So, you know, I will often get asked or when someone meets me, they'll say, I love Indian food, right? Or like, you know, I love Indian movies and that's great, but you know, I'm not the representative for all of India, right? Like I put that on Black women or put that on, you know, someone from Mexico. It's a whole different set of questions and set of, you know, responsibility that comes with walking in the world is that when you're the only, right, you become like the beacon for every question and every thought. And then there's just this sense of like, you can't fail. Right. And a lot of these women have been told they have to work. I've heard everything from 2 to 4x as hard. So you have to be twice as good to get, you know, half ahead. You have to be 4 times as good. And we've all been told that in different ways. And most women, I think, believe that too, right? Because we're competing in a male world and we can't mess up and we feel that pressure. But these women, I feel it on even a higher level. So it's almost what I think a lot of white women feel, but it's just amped up a little bit because there's even more eyes on you. There's a sense you cannot fail. And they walk with that, right? And it shows up in illnesses, it shows up in stress, it shows up on just feeling on guard. But a lot of the time, I think what you're doing is you're looking around and you're realizing that there's all these things that are unsaid that you carry. And so my work right now is really about asking yourself, like, what do you want to shed as you walk in the world, right? Like, what are those responsibilities that are thrust upon you or that you've been taught that don't work for you anymore and you want to get rid of? And what are some of the things that we can actually bring to the world because of who we are and how we were raised? And we don't often get to talk about that, right? I mean, I think there was a lot that I did and I've even done as a corporate person to hide who I was, right? The fact that my experience at home was different than my white colleagues, because it wasn't always something that you wanted to show how you were different, right? You really wanted to fit in. So, you know, I think you and I may have even had this conversation. There used to be a lot of discussion about should women, you know, learn about, you know, football or sports, you know, details on the weekend if they weren't really into it. And there was a camp of women who used to say yes, because on Monday and Tuesday, you want to talk about what happened over the weekend. And then there was a camp of women who said, no, because that's not really what I'm interested in. So I'm not going to waste my time learning, right? And it's kind of that conversation, but in a slightly different way, right? How much do we give up and how much do we edit ourselves, honestly, to kind of fit in and not be different? Because there's not really a reward for being different all the time. And I think that's really what this work is about. And that pressure to edit yourself shows up in really contorted ways over time.